In this illustration, we'll study the steady state analysis of RC circuits. Here, in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the steady state charges on both the capacitors after a long time after closing the switch. If the switch is closed initially, transient phenomena will take place and gradually charges on capacitor will increase, and finally in a steady state that will reach a constant value. And we know well that in a steady state, the current through capacitor branches becomes zero because capacitors are fully charged. So finally, in a steady state, we can say through this 20 volt battery, current will flow only in this outer loop. So here we can write, in a steady state, current through battery is, the value of current we can calculate as this 20 divided by the total resistance of this loop is 5 ohm. So this is 4 ampere. And if we calculate the potential difference across this system, here we can say it will be the potential difference across 1 ohm because this 1 ohm, this branch are connected in parallel. So if we calculate the potential difference across 1 ohm resistance is, this potential difference we can write as IR, that is 4 multiplied by 1, this is 4 volt. So the potential difference across this section as well as this section is also 4 volt. And as no current is flowing through these 6 ohm and 2 ohm resistances, here potential and here potential, and this potential will be equal. So we can say across both of these capacitances, the potential difference will be 4 volt. So here now we can write the steady state charge on 4 microfarad capacitor is CV. So it is 4 multiplied by 4, this is 16 microcoulomb. And charge on 2 microfarad capacitor in a steady state will be 2V. That is 2 into 4, that is equals to 8 microcoulomb. And both of these would be the answers of this problem.